Hey. Are you all right? I'm sorry, can I take a look, please?
Oh, there's nothing to look at. Better give me an injection.
Oh my God. I'm afraid this will have to... If we don't amputate it, you won't survive the afternoon.
Our prison doctor, he told me the same thing. Word for word. But that was over a week ago.
And he didn't do anything?
Sadly, the only surgical equipment he had was a rusty wash basin.
Very funny.
All right. All right. Don't worry. It should be like that. Only like that. I'm also talking to God.
To God? Great. You need to get up if you don't want to lose something else to frostbite.
Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa.
What do you mean you talk to God?
What? Oh, my arm. You've seen my arm, yes? It's been a week or more.
I doubt it. And what does God have to do with this?
Well, let me explain. Ever since that night, everything, every event, it all happened as I was told it would. I'm certain I was the only one who left that train alive. It's all going according to plan. Every fucking step is God's plan, do you understand?
So taking me hostage was God's plan?
I know what you're thinking. But remember the gospel. The father who gave his money to the prodigal son, not to the beloved one, the good one, but to the bandit. He who had been murdering and stealing but came back. He came back. Do you understand? I think the Lord is happier to see one repentant sinner than 100,000 righteous people. I don't know. They don't even need repentance. Do you hear me? You know, he laid everything out before me. Spread out like a deck of cards, the past, the present, the future.
Who?
God, who else? I was lying there, about to die. And a sister, just like you, brought me some water in this mug. And I was drinking and I saw ripples in the water. Little round waves. And heard a whisper. So I drank. And...
You heard God in a cup?
In a cup, yes. But that's not the point. I'll show you when we get there.
Look, a water tower. That means the station is behind the windmill.
A station? Why? We're doing fine.
We've only got fuel for a couple of bursts. I won't be able to drag you around with no steam.
Okay, das ist jetzt die Szene eigentlich, die wir hier kennen von der Demo her. Mal wissen wir eigentlich, was hier passiert. Wenn nicht unbedingt was geändert wurde. Mal schauen.
Maybe we should go around.
A nun and an officer? Who cares?
But the telegraph poles. The cables are ripped out though.
And the road. Doesn't look like it's been used lately.
Do this. It's as if they blocked the passage on purpose. Come.
The brake is rusted shut. I have to find something to get rid of the screw.
It won't fucking budge.
Und wir wissen auch schon, wo und was. Aber trotzdem schauen wir uns noch kurz hier um. Könnten wir theoretisch eigentlich ganz zurücklaufen wahrscheinlich. Mache ich aber jetzt nicht. Hier waren Jahre schon niemand mehr. Noch mehr Punkte, die uns nichts bringen, sehr schön. Das Leben des Gottes Lieblings Bartholomäus. Der heilige Bartholomäus war ein Einsiedler von solcher Milde und Frömmigkeit, dass selbst wilde Tiere ihn nicht scheuten. Er fütterte Vögel, Eichhörnchen und Schlangen. Selbst ein Bär besuchte ihn von Zeit zu Zeit, um von Bartholomäus Erdbeerkonfitüre zu naschen. Einmal kam es zwischen ihm und den Bären zum Streit, den sie nicht mit Worten lösen konnten. Wütend schlug Bartholomäus mit der Axt nach dem Bären. Als er sah, was er getan hatte, fiel Bartholomäus zu Boden, wälzte sich in seinen Tränen und bat Gott und den Bären um Vergebung. Gut, wenn du ihn mit der Axt angegriffen hast, kannst du dann wohl nicht mehr viel machen. Weil er dann wahrscheinlich tot ist. Ansonsten gibt es hier nichts, was uns irgendwie helfen könnte oder spannend wäre. Und hier hinten auch nichts.
So?
Not yet. Maybe there's something in that shed.
Und wir wissen auch, was da drin ist. Das war das Haus mit den ganzen Bildern, wo die ganzen Gesichter keine Augen haben. Was sehr weird ist. Kein einziges Bild hat Augen. Das Leben des heiligen Johannes. Eines Tages fiel der ehrwürdige Johannes in eine Grube. Er war ein gottesfürchtiger und frommer Mönch. Also blieb er demütig in der Grube. Am dritten Tag verzweifelte er. Hatte er aus Feigheit die Prüfung des Herrn mit dessen Willen verwechselt? Sollte er am Boden der Grube in seinem eigenen Unrat sitzen und aus der Dunkelheit ins Licht steigen? Johannes begann zu Gott zu beten und er gab Johannes sofort ein Zeichen. Ein Fichtenzweig neigte sich in die Grube hinab. Johannes ergriff den Zweig und erstieg aus dem Loch. Und entstieg dem Loch. Nachdem er begriff, dass er in seiner Anmaßung von Dämonen versucht worden war, weinte Johannes. Ängstlich sprang er zurück in die Grube und flehte um Vergebung. Gott vergab Johannes und beschenkte ihn mit vielerlei geistigen Gaben. Und wenn er nicht aus der Grube auferstiegen ist, ist er noch immer in der Grube. Wieder Punkte, die uns nichts bringen. Und eine unglaublich schöne Puppe. Und da ist der Schuppen. Da ging es ja, glaube ich, nicht hinein, außer sie haben was geändert. Nope, wir müssen da über die Leiter hoch.
I've missed this smell.
Schraubenschlüssel. Indica konnte einen 5er und einen 40er Schraubenschlüssel mühelos unterscheiden. Dieser hier war irgendwas dazwischen. Gut, das kann ich auch noch. Fragment einer Klappikone. O Herr, reinige uns von unseren Sünden. O Sohn Gottes, vergib uns unsere Frevel. O Heiliger Geist, komm zu uns und heile uns unseren Gebrechen. Noch nie gesehen sowas? Ja, doch, den Schraubenschlüssel hat sie mitgenommen. Ich dachte gerade, warum gehen wir sonst hier hinein?
So?
Found a wrench.
Give it to me.
Klar, gleich. Können wir bei der Puppe hier beten? Okay, bringt nichts. Hätte ja sein können. Dann mal schauen.
What's that?
Just a dog. Calm down.
I hate them. Hurry up.
Gut, das Fahrrad können wir jetzt nicht wieder mitnehmen irgendwie.
Schön. Quiet, little doggy. We won't hurt you.
Are you crazy? Run.
Auch der kleine Hund ist so groß wie alle anderen Tiere. Kudetz.
You know, I would have already fucked you up with my bare hands if I wanted. Well, hand.
Why?
Why the fuck did you throw away the revolver? It would have been useful. I mean, a girl. I would never. Oh, shit!
Tell me something. If you're God's chosen one, why didn't God heal you completely right away?
That's a good question. Here's your answer. Here. Here.
Gudetz. 20. März. Tempel des Johannes von Damaskus. Basov. Die einzige vernünftige Heilung für Unfruchtbarkeit, Trunkenheit, Untreue und andere körperliche Gebrechen sowie Leiden der Seele. Okay, ist das irgendwie so eine Gebetsstätte? Kenne ich nicht, sagt mir nichts.
The cadets.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly. Come on.
I don't understand. So God had enough power only to stop the rotting, but to heal you completely, he needed some kind of tool.
Look, it's not about the tool. A man can't be saved against his will, you see. Basically, look, yeah, it has nothing to do with my arm. It's about the path we've been given, and whether to follow it or not. It's up to us.
What do I have to do with it? So, possessed people are taken to the Kadyats?
Everybody is. Do I look possessed to you?
No, not you. All right, let's get out of here.
Well, hoist yourselves.
Hoist me up.
Me hoist you up?
Yes, you. You won't be able to pull me up from up there. Shit.
Ilya? Are you alive? Ilya!
Yeah. All right.
Yeah.
What's going on?
Sag doch irgendwas.
Of course it wasn't a coincidence, and now Indica realized it too. She had heard about the Kudets and its miracles, but right now, in Spasov, and Ilya, meeting a prisoner who talks to God would not be an everyday occurrence. Also, Indica took a liking to him.
Who, this one? No.
One way or another, there was certainly no doubt that she had to head for Spasov and not the Danilov Monastery.
The letter! I cannot neglect my duty. What if there's something important in it?
Open it. See for yourself.
No! Reading someone else's letter is a greater sin than not delivering it.
Greater? How much greater?
Twice as much. I don't know.
Interesting. So, not delivering two letters is the same as reading one. What about stealing? Pocketing a ruble, for example. Is that worse?
Worse.
How much worse?
This is nonsense. You can't compare such things.
Why not? The priest imposes a different penance for different sins, and since you know for sure which is better or worse, there has to be a way of measuring. Then let us say that stealing is 10 times worse than not delivering a letter. What about murder? Let us put that at 1,000 letters. That would mean that if a postman were to lose a sack full of letters, we'd have a murderer. Although, maybe there should be a bulk discount. What about a rapist? A rapist is better than a murderer, right?
Irgendwie weirde Vergleiche.